I suppose if I went back into the archives of all of my blabs and stuff that I put online, this has been said before, but it's reoccurring to me right now, is that we all have a disorder of some sort. And it should lead to humility. I think because they're disorders, they don't, but it should. Some people have a complaining disorder, some people have a supremacy, a sense of of supremacy disorder. Others have a lying disorder. I had that happen this week. It's just weird, and it's almost, I wonder if it's genetic, because a sibling of this kid had the same thing, would hold on to a lie until you videotaped it and then could say, "I'm going to show it to you." And it's like, so I mean, some of these things are hardwired. I can see my disorder in my children a little bit, and that would be, and that disorder is, mine I think would be called excess or extreme intensity disorder. Now, that being said, I like it. I think it leads to good and bad, and I don't want to use it as an excuse. I've made people mad over the years, and I've gotten under people's skin, but I think that the good of it is I have lived life, and I continue to, and I continue to love life, and it's that intensity that does that. Also, though, it leads to hurt feelings. I'm not a sycophant. I'm not very good at playing the game. I just say what's on my mind. That's part of my intensity, and I don't want to use that as an excuse and say that should make everything right. It really shouldn't. It's the good and the bad of of my deal, and but I like it in the sense that I think it makes my teaching dynamic. I think it makes my relationships that are good, the connections, extremely real, extremely intense. Probably makes the dislikes of me extremely intense, probably, and I'm okay with that. I guess that's part of my EID. But I think that everybody's got something. Not everybody wants to face that, and through facing it, that's where humility comes in. And there's all, I mean, we could make a list of 20 disorders, and I don't mean this as a joke. I think it's very real, and it keeps us, I think the disorders keep us from just being the most efficient person we can be in loving life to the extent and loving others as much as we can, because my disorder keeps me from loving people. For sure. I have intense feelings. They're not mellow. If I could mellow out, but if I did mellow out, there are things about me that I wouldn't like. I like the fact that life has run the way it has. I like the things that I've been involved in. And so part of it is embracing that and having a humility surrounding that. And it's not a joke. I'm not kidding. I mean, people say, "Oh, that's funny that you diagnosed yourself with EID and you take blood pressure medication, right?" Yes, I do, and I think that's part of my disorder. I'm not kidding. I really do feel like this. And but before you get too excited and like, "Ah, oh, that explains a lot about Neil," you got one too. And you might want to search out what that is, because I guarantee if you search long and hard enough, it will come to the surface. And it's okay. It leads to humility, and that will lead to better understanding and better compassion, I think. But it's tough. I hope that everybody has a good November, and I hope that we have our Halloween party today, so I hope that goes over well too. Have a good day, everybody.